Hey guys, be forewarned that this video is chock full of Avatar The Last Airbender spoilers, and also some Legend of Korra spoilers, amongst other random ones as well. Be forewarned. Oh my bad, I already said that. Anyway, y'all have been warned. Okay, on to the video.
Hi everyone.
It's been a minute since I even attempted video, but your girl just had a lot of thoughts about Avatar The Last Airbender. And what better way to process those thoughts than spill them all out, my history with Avatar The Last Airbender. For some reason, it just completely went over me and I don't know why, but I'm here now. Your girl's late to the party, but she's here. After watching it the first time, there are a lot of opinions that I had, a lot of emotions, a lot of interesting. This is the second time recording this video. We're gonna start with season one and work our way from there. Your girl has notes. She has a whole thing of notes. If I'm looking down, it's because my laptop is right here out of frame. This show, I watched through it the first time, watched it again to take notes, and now I'm watching it a third time. It's just been Avatar this whole quarantine. It's great. I did also watch Legend of Korra. I did. So the whole show, starting with season one. All right, here we go. You know what? I'm just gonna enjoy this.
Aang, this is the entire village. Entire village, Aang.
I didn't realize how small the Southern Water Tribe is. She and Sokka are the oldest kids there. It's like 15 people. Also, upon rewatching, Katara's voice is a lot more youthful sounding in these first few episodes. Interesting. I would love to do this. Katara says, I haven't done this since I was a kid. And Aang says, you still are a kid. The subtext being, I consider myself on another level, maturity level, age level. She's already putting a distinction between the two of them. Just in those two lines. Yeah, I'm a kid, but I'm not like a kid like you. See what I mean? I forgot that they interact with Zuko as early as episode 2. I totally forgot about that. Wow. Not Gran. Zuko.
Get it. We're going to save your boyfriend.
He's not my-
Whatever.
So, Sokka calls Aang Katara's boyfriend once. There's several different people that are referred to as Katara's boyfriend, right? How she reacts to that title being tossed around is very interesting each time. So I have to give credit where credit's due. Katara acts all indignant to Aang this one time. He's not my boyfriend. I love Suki.
I am a warrior. But I'm a girl too.
The cabbage guy. Oh my goodness. First time I watched season one, I was into it, but I was also getting a little frustrated. We find out Aang needs to learn how to bend all the elements, and we have to go to the Northern Water Tribe to learn waterbending. I'm like, cool. But then Aang is like, oh, let's stop here. Let's play around here. Let's go ride big koi fish. And I'm going, wait a second. We have a mission here. Can we get to the North Pole? I don't want all this fluff. Kyoshi Warriors, Omashu. These feel like random stops. Obviously, everything comes back into play, but for the first time watching everything through, you don't know that. And we don't get to the North Pole until the last two episodes. Oh my gosh, it's Haru. I think almost instantly I started pairing people, like potential ships. My roommate called me Yenta. I was Yenta from season one, episode 3.
That lemur is earthbending.
You idiot, it's the girl.
That's funny.
Earthbenders, I am your warden. I prefer to think of you not as prisoners, but as honored guests.
Hello. I know that voice. Awaken the Great Stone Dragon.
Awaken the Great Stone Dragon.
This is him.
Dad, this is Katara.
Have some dinner, Katara.
First time watching the show. When Haru came on the scene, I was like, oh, okay, he's cute. But then the second time around, I was like, look at Haru's dad with the voice. Keep talking, sir.
I'm sorry. We're powerless.
We'll see about that.
Arthur Fist. Yes.
Thank you for helping me find my courage, Katara of the Water Tribe. My family and everyone here owes you much.
Am I the only one? I was looking him up. I was like, who is this?
I only wish there was some way.
Okay, so if you haven't guessed it yet, I'm a big Zuko Katara fan. There, I said it. I kind of forgot. When did I officially start shipping them? It was really early, but then when I watched it back, I remembered. I started shipping them.
It's gone.
Right? There, right there. That's when I started shipping Zuko and Katara. He's looking into the sunset? What? With the necklace in hand? What? So to me, it was clear just from that that they were gonna get together. Yeah. And here's what I'm gonna say too. Watching this show multiple times, I don't see how you could be anything but a Zuko Katara fan. Did we watch the same show? Did we not see the same clues? I'm not making this stuff up. All the reasons for them to be Endgame are written into the show. I'm gonna try to be as impartial as possible, but just know your girl has a preference and I'm not trying to hide it.
Sokka!
Uncle!
In the next episode, their storylines are being paralleled. They both lost a family member. Katara lost Sokka to that panda beast. Zuko lost his uncle. How? Oh yeah, he was in that rock hot tub and got captured. Again, what is happening? Why aren't we at the North Pole yet, y'all? And then their paths are crossing, guys.
Please don't go, Aang. The world can't afford to lose you to the Fire Nation. Neither can I.
I don't like that. This was hilarious. The fire melts the chains, but our squad doesn't have a scratch on them. Okay, writers, sure. We've made contact. Official contact.
Tell me where he is, and I won't hurt you or your brother.
Go jump in the river.
You guys.
I need to capture him to restore something I've lost. My honor.
Honestly, he's talking very frank and open to her. So we'll take what we can get. In episode 2, he was yelling. In this one, he's kind of just like, hey, lost my honor. Got a scar. I kind of need to find the Avatar. Ooh, that rhymed. He's whispering in her ear, girl. Also, he's had this necklace for multiple episodes, just in his pocket. Pining! Can't tell me otherwise. He doesn't know that he can use the necklace to find them until multiple episodes later. Just tucked away, you know, because. Y'all. Y'all.
Hey.
Hi.
My name is Jet.
Jet's tall. For a kid. Another love interest for Katara. She's just raking him in.
Your boyfriend Jet's a thug.
What? No, he's not.
Did you see that? Another boyfriend comment from Sokka. She didn't say he wasn't her boyfriend. She said he wasn't a thug. The girl has caught feelings. You see how she had to walk into the shadow to talk to Jet? He's in the shadows. Writers, I see you. I don't write this show. I observe.
Zuko would have to duel his own father.
Zuko got half his face burnt off. Just because he said what everyone was thinking in a work meeting. On the conference call, he just made a little quip. Ew. I don't like how I said that. Had a little side comment. He gets half his face burnt off at 13. That's rough. Also, I don't think I said this the first time around. I really do like how they don't show his father's face until season 3. It's cool because it adds intrigue to the father and a bit of intimidation without any words.
Aang needs to have freedom and fun. You cannot keep protecting him from his destiny.
Whoop, we got another Mulan voice. What's his name? I do not squeal like a girl. Chifu. Chifu. Oh, then here we go. Blue spirit. Zuko's the blue spirit of all the colors to pick. Blue, like water, matching with the future wife. Okay, he was using his swords, then he doused him with a bucket of water. Y'all.
If we knew each other back then, do you think we could have been friends too?
I love this conversation between Aang and Zuko. It was very sweet, very poignant, and very well done.
I made you a necklace, Katara.
Oh my gosh, Aang made Katara a necklace that we never see again. What does that say? Aang's love for Katara doesn't mean anything. It's not substantial because it's not reciprocated. He made her a necklace to replace her old one, and we only see it in this episode. It's gone. But this is our endgame couple. Writers.
Aang's just a good friend. Just like Momo.
Katara legit says Aang is just a friend. She doesn't see him that way. And here's, okay. Aang is 12. 112. Katara is 14. That would be like a 6th, 7th grader having a crush on an 8th, 9th grader. A middle schooler and a high schooler. Ain't no 8th, 9th grader looking at a 6th, 7th grader in a romantic way. At least not at their age. It makes sense for him to have a crush on her. That's fine. It doesn't make sense for her to look down at this little 12-year-old like, you know what? I want that. If we fast forward 20 years, that's another story, but they're kids. It's Meng. Oh! The first watch through, I loved her. The second watch through, I loved her. And I couldn't figure out why. I couldn't put my finger on it. Oh, look at them. Again, Yenta, she's back. The first time I watched this, when I got to this episode, I was like, oh, this is the one. Aang, get with Meng. One, because their names rhyme, and that's cute. Two, she likes him just because of his ears. A lot of the little girls that were pining after Aang are really kind of looking at him because he's the Avatar, but she doesn't know that. I find that very refreshing.
I can see the man you're going to marry. Tell me more. He's a very powerful bender.
All right, the fortune teller said powerful bender, not Avatar. There is a difference. Aang is more than a powerful bender. Even when people meet Aang, their first conclusion is, oh, you're an airbender. But the grander conclusion is, oh, you're the Avatar. It's a cut above being just a bender. It's even in the title of the show. It's Avatar first, last airbender second. So if the fortune teller had seen Katara with Aang, she would have said, I can see you're going to marry the Avatar. Or she would have said something more specific. But she said powerful bender. That can mean anybody. I think I know who it means. But we'll put that aside for now. The fact that Aang is leaping for joy is a bit presumptuous. Calm down, Aang.
Anything about a girl? You wanna know about love? I'm sorry, but I didn't see anything.
So, the fortune teller saw no love in Aang's future. Okay, and I get it. The fortune teller is not the most accurate person, but that just further cements she wasn't talking about Aang to Katara. Guys.
Sometimes I forget what a powerful bender that kid is.
Wait, what did you just say?
Aang is one powerful bender.
I suppose he is.
I hate it. And not just because I want her to be with Zuko. There are a couple times in the show where I get a little disappointed in how they convey certain things. Sometimes it gets a little, powerful bender. That's what the fortune teller said. We get it. You're beating us over the head with it. Also, the more realistic reaction is, oh, is the fortune teller telling me that I'm about to marry this 12-year-old? I guess he is a powerful bender. Oh. That's the more realistic reaction. Not this dazzle-eyed, completely euphoric response. Again, this is all my opinion. I have a friend that is pro Katara and Aang. I love hearing her side of things because we watch the same show and she's coming to the completely 180 conclusion. It's always healthy. It's always respectful. I can already feel the ship wars coming in the comments. That's not what this video is for. This is just my take on it. But if you ship Katara and Aang, that's totally fine.
It's canon.
Whatever. Take care.
Floozy.
She's so cute. Oh. Pippi Longstocking Sheik. I wish he had given her a chance. I really do.
Drinks on me.
Okay, so here's another girl that I really love. June. Every time she speaks, for the most part, she is promoting the Zuko Katara ship. Nice necklace. Is that your girlfriend's? Who's that? She's your girlfriend, right? Yes, June. Yes, she is. I see you. We see each other. And then again, writers, why would you put her in the show and have her keep calling Katara Zuko's girlfriend if you're not gonna follow through with that? June is like me put in the show. You didn't have to put me in the show if you don't want what I say to influence how the show ends. I feel like I'm getting very heated right now. Okay, finally the necklace is put to use several episodes later. Katara scent to the, what's it called? Katara scent is purple. Purple? Purple, like the colors blue and red put together. Purple, like the best color ever, purple. But purple, Zuko red, Katara blue, purple. Again, I didn't write this show. I am just commenting on what is in front of my face. Woo!
Well,
no.
Yes.
Ah!
Hand them over.
This hard to cut down because I was just enjoying the battle. They don't see it yet, but they really do suit each other. They're well paired, skill-wise. They're on the same kind of level. Oh my gosh. I love Ko. I think he's such a cool villain. The concept of him, the idea that he steals your face if you make an emotion, brilliant. I wish we had seen more of Ko throughout the show, or even in Korra. He's only in this episode, which is sad. Props to Aang for that, because I love that their power sources are opposites. I'm all about yin and yang, complementary. Oh, I don't even keep it in. The Tui and Law, I don't think their personalities are that opposite, actually. I think they both have very quick tempers, but also really sweet on the inside. But where they draw their power sources are night and day, and that's really cool. I love it. And that's all I really had for season one. Overall, season one, in retrospect, I like it a little bit better. But when I was watching it the first time, it took so long to get to the North Pole. I didn't even include it, but Yue and all of that, it doesn't have as much of an emotional impact because we only had 2 episodes with her. And then there was just a lot of general silliness. I'm glad Roku finally tells him you only get 4 months to do this because Aang was not taking this seriously and it was very frustrating because I was taking this very seriously from the start. We're gonna go on to season two. Season two. You know how we're gonna start season two, right? Secret tunnel, secret tunnel. Through the mountains, secret, 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 secret tunnel. I almost lost my headphones.
Fire Nation has hurt you. It's okay. They've hurt me too.
Hold on. I like this perspective that Zuko's getting on how much damage that the Fire Nation has done.
Us kissing?
Yeah, I definitely wouldn't want to kiss you.
Oh.
I mean, if it was a choice between kissing you and dying.
Ah! Well, I'm not sure which I would rather do.
What is wrong with me?
Nothing, Aang. You're just a 112-year-old boy. Guys, their faces literally went. Then the light went out, and then the lights went on in the ceiling. My question is, if you have to kiss for the lights to come on, then what's the point of the lights? You have to... The lights are for you to find each other. You can't find each other and kiss each other if there's no lights. I don't know. That didn't look like a kiss to me. Progress and halt and pitch black. But everyone's so convinced that that's their first kiss. I'm still unsure.
Ty Lee, could that possibly be you? Azula!
I love Ty Lee. Ty Lee is here. She has arrived. Thank God.
What is the daughter of a nobleman doing here? Certainly our parents didn't send us to the Royal Fire Academy for girls to end up in places like this.
Yes, Azula. Queen. Work the exposition!
In the swamp, we see visions of people we've lost. People we love.
We're in the swamp episode now. This was even further proof that Katara was not the one for Aang. He says in the swamp, we see people we've lost, people we loved. Sokka sees Yue. Love, I think, is a little generous. They didn't really talk about much because she kept being like, oh! And running away. Very teen romance. Katara loved and lost her mother. Who does Aang see? Someone that he hasn't met yet. Just from seeing that, I was like, oh, okay. That is the bae for Aang. I don't know who she is. We haven't met her yet, but I'm ready. She looks age appropriate. She's such a huge part of Aang's life that he's had a vision of her before he's even met her. Little did I know. So I will give them this. He runs towards the unknown girl and she turns into Katara. So you could argue he saw Katara as Toph. Katara is the true love. Toph was the illusion. I don't know. I'm trying to give some bones to the Aang Katara side.
It's the Avatar himself! Avatar Aang saved us.
What? Chifu voice again. I recognize Chifu.
The blind!
She's here. Toph is here! Ooh. This reveal, this entrance was so fantastic. She hadn't even said anything. And I was already like, yes, yes, yes. Now that she's here. I don't know if you guys know this already, but back when I was like, I love Meng. Why do I love Meng? I looked up who the voice actress of Meng was. And the same actress, Jessie Michaela, that voiced Meng, also voiced my favorite character, Toph. Toph. Toffee. Love her. And I love Aang's reaction. Yes, Aang. Yes. Yes! Yes!
What's your problem? What's your problem?
I love that they don't instantly get along. She pushes him, challenges him. That's what Aang needs. I haven't even delved into the very mother-son relationship that Katara and Aang have. I haven't even addressed that yet. Regardless of whether you think Katara is a mother to Aang or not, Katara coddles Aang. She really does.
Look, I'm sorry about dinner. Let's call a truce, okay? I feel the vibrations in the earth with earth bending. I can see you, that tree, even those ants.
That's amazing.
It is amazing.
There are plenty of amazing earthbenders out there.
Not like her.
Not like her, absolutely. Shut up, Katara. How dare she? Yay, Toph joins the gang. This is when season two really comes alive.
Ever since you joined us, you've been nothing but selfish and unhelpful. What? Look here, sugar queen.
Look here, sugar tits. In my mind, that's what she really wanted to say.
I gave up everything I had so that I could teach Aang earthbending. So don't you talk to me about being selfish. Sugar queen?
There's something after us and we don't even know what or who it is.
It could be Zuko.
Oh, excuse me. Katara keeping track of Zuko, future Bay.
Who's Zuko?
Oh, just some angry freak with a ponytail.
What's wrong with ponytails, ponytail?
And then defending Bay's trash hairstyle. You could do a whole dissertation on how Zuko's redemption arc is illustrated through his hair. I can't believe she's defending that ponytail. That's love. She doesn't even know it yet. She doesn't even know.
Zuko, I can help.
She offers to help. That's something. Ugh. Here we go. Aang and Toph being future husband and wife. Perfect episode. I love it.
I've been training Aang for a while now. He really responds well to kind words. Maybe a gentle nudge in the right direction.
Thanks, Katara. I'll try that.
Yes. Oh, I love it. Yes. It's fantastic. It's all fantastic.
Fire is the element of power. Water is the element of change.
Power and change. That's fire and water. Having the power to change summarizes the whole show to me. Also the fact that he's literally drawing out Katara's necklace in the sand. I don't know how much more obvious we can get here, people.
The technique I am about to teach you is one I learned by studying the waterbender.
He's about to learn waterbending. They're waterbending. Oh my gosh.
If fire and water are opposites, then what's the opposite of air?
I guess it's earth.
That's why it's so hard. You're working with your natural opposite.
Sue me. I'm a sucker for opposites attract. Two people that seemingly don't really go together come together. I love that they're opposites. That makes me want them to be together. And I love that Zuko and Katara are opposites. That to me means they should be together.
Stop the rock. Like this.
Are you sure this is really the best way to teach Aang earthbending?
I love how Katara had the audacity to try to correct Toph. Are you the number one earthbender in the world? No, you're not. Why don't you sit down? It's not that I dislike Katara, but she is legit babying Aang. And Aang has to learn this. So,
Prince Zuko, pride is not the opposite of shame, but its source.
Pride is not the opposite of shame, but its source. Dang. I'll give flowers where flowers are due. Writers, that's a beautiful line. It's one that really sticks with me.
Enough! I want my staff back! Do it now! What? Earthbend, Twinkle Toes. But do it!
Yes, she knew exactly what to do to get the results that he needed.
You're an earthbender.
You tried the positive reinforcement, didn't you?
Yep, it worked wonders.
I wish Toph had just told her off right there. I don't like that Katara thinks that she had anything to do with the results that Toph brought out of Aang. Toph is a little bit nicer than I would have been at that moment, and that just makes her even more of a queen.
Enjoy the library.
Hey, look at these weird lion turtle things.
Okay, I'm putting this in so that we can come back to this. The girl has thoughts. They did somewhat foreshadow that lion turtles are a thing. We'll get to it.
Okay. Aang, did you know in a past life you were left-handed?
I always knew I was special.
Oh my gosh, I did not remember that. A shout out to us lefties. That was so sweet. Oh my goodness.
Next. Oh my God.
So see, this is when stuff from season one is coming back and I'm like, okay, this is really good.
My name is Ta Fei Fong and I'll need 4 tickets.
Oh.
It's just further proof that Toph is a queen and everybody knows it. Everybody. I'm in awe. In awe.
As you can see, I am blind and these 3 imbeciles are my valets.
Imbeciles.
We scanned that lady good.
I've seen your type before.
Do I know you?
Maybe you remember this.
Suki!
Ah! Yay! Suki's back. I love them. Love Suki and Sokka. Before Sokka met Suki, he was very misogynistic and a jerk. All it took was one episode. One episode! Now all of a sudden, he's all about female empowerment and all about the queens. She did all that work in one day. One fight. One costume change. Don't sleep on Suki now. Suki's great. I'm glad she's back.
What I'd give to be a metal bender.
How about being married to a metal bender, Aang? Goodness. Am I really shiny? If I was the Avatar and I had a crush on Katara, understandable. But then I had a vision. I had a vision of someone else that I had not even met yet. Then I meet that person and it turns out to be Toph Beifong? Katara who? I would be immediately pursuing Toph. I keep doing this. Woo! Boys.
Hi Lee, my name's Jin.
Oh, speaking of boys.
What do you like to do for fun?
Nothing.
Suko! I only caught this when I was editing. Justice for Jin. She's trying to work with him, but he's just like not giving her anything.
Would you and your girlfriend care for dessert?
She is not my girlfriend!
Okay, we got another label being thrown out. Homeboy called Jin his girlfriend. He got all indignant. And then what ends up happening? They kiss. Keep all this in mind, alright? So there were certain things that I didn't realize were as iconic as they ended up being. The Cabbage Man, Secret Tunnel. When I first watched it, I was just like, okay. And I wasn't in hysterics when I first heard Leaves from the Vine. But then when all the stuff happened this past summer with George Floyd and all the protests, even now, all the ridiculousness and frightening racism in the summer, I sat down so tired and I just played this over and over and cried. It was the song, but it was more what he says right before, which is the...
If only I could have helped you. Leaves from the vine. Falling so slow.
I am.
Like fragile, tiny
shell. This is not her car.
Would not apply to those who are here illegal.
So
man, you
with the more people that they bring back. So Jet's back. One thing I will say about Jet is I feel like he's not a foil, he's a front runner to Zuko. Katara had romantic feelings for Jet. He betrays her. She has a very visceral mistrust and anger towards him. And that very much foreshadows how she's gonna deal with Zuko. Spoilers. Later on this season and in season 3. Storytelling wise, that's cool. She really doesn't handle being betrayed well.
Don't worry, Katara. I'll be fine.
She's lying.
Brilliant. Brilliant. Honestly, RIP Jet. That was done so well. That was not on the nose. He's a powerful bender. A powerful bender. That was subtle and that was more emotionally effective. Appa's back. I totally left out all the stuff with Appa because I just didn't want to deal with it. Look at Queen and King dominating with the earth bending, working together, looking flawless together. Oh my goodness. Yes. Lord.
a solar eclipse.
Really?
Azula's a great villain. She's no Ko. I know people love her. I don't love her. She's crazy. But I think for the purposes of the show, she's great.
The fire chakra deals with willpower and is blocked by shame. This chakra deals with pleasure and is blocked by guilt.
The water chakra is blocked by guilt and the fire chakra is blocked by shame. Those seem very similar to me. Shame is more deep than guilt, but the fact that those two chakras are blocked by kind of similar things is interesting. I'm not saying that that's a Zuko Katara thing. I'm just saying.
Same hold.
Oh my gosh.
Even lucky is just a part of Earth that is purified and refined.
Toph, you rule.
Just when you think you couldn't get any better, Toph gets better. What is happening on my screen? I don't deserve. The lovers are crossing paths.
Jasmine, one green and one lychee.
I'm brewing as fast as I can.
Ow! And then you get overwhelmed with emotion, so you run away. Ow! Okay, so then we get a guru telling Aang to let go of Katara. And he's like, I can't. Yes, you can't. Aang, this is a bigger thing here. You understand me? This is when I get frustrated. Now the show is like, let her go, let her go.
Katara's in danger. I have to go.
If you leave now, you won't be able to go into the Avatar state at all.
And he still goes. Aang, I understand that you love Katara. I understand that. But I need you to look a little bit outside of just what you want. Because you're the Avatar. This is what I wrote. Let her go, Aang. Save the world. You need the Avatar state. You know what this is like? Ted and Robin. Should we go down that rabbit hole? If you guys haven't watched How I Met Your Mother, spoilers, sort of. Ted thinks that Robin is the one. But we as the audience know, no, Ted, someone else is coming. Someone better. Someone that you're going to fall in love with and have a happy life with. Let Robin go, because he keeps coming back to Robin. And then finally, he lets her go. She remembered that weird. It was weird. She went up in the sky, levitated. This is the exact same thing. Do you guys feel that way?
I am the greatest earthbender in the world.
Oh. Queen Toph at it again. I know that Toph and Sokka is a ship. We'll get to it in a little bit later. But I will acknowledge she's very much cuddled. Interesting. Girl, cuddle with Aang over here.
It went great with the guru.
So Aang lied. Doesn't that block a chakra? Aang, isn't that kind of against your principles as a monk? Aang, you can't let Katara go, but you can lie. Okay. Yes! Ah!
Zuko!
Oh Lord. Our couple is back together.
You're a terrible person, you know that?
She really holds a grudge. Which I'm not, that's just her character, that's fine. It's a consistent thing and it was well done. I'm just commenting here, I'm like, dang. Katara.
But what do you care? You're the Fire Lord's son. Spreading war and violence and hatred is in your blood.
You don't know what you're talking about.
I don't?
Not only does she hold a grudge, she's very confident that what she believes is 100% fact, and she won't listen to anything else. That to me is more annoying than the mothering part.
You have no idea what this war has put me through. Me personally. The Fire Nation took my mother away from me.
I'm sorry. That's something we have in common.
Oh, wow. Look at that, Katara. Had you just shut up for a second, he could have shown you that you guys have more in common than you think.
It's an old friend of mine. Glad to see you're okay.
You guys know each other?
I love that Toph and Iroh are like this. Because greatness recognizes greatness. Understand? They're buds. I love how Toph is always one step ahead.
So, Toph thinks you give pretty good advice. And great tea.
The key to both is proper aging. What's on your mind?
Aang took his bae Toph's advice. He was listening. Ugh. Also, the fact that this episode is called The Crossroads of Destiny, and we have Zuko and Katara interacting. Interesting. Interesting! How many times am I gonna say interesting?
I've realized I'm free to determine my own destiny.
I love that they're connecting. I love that they're connecting.
Maybe you could be free. I don't know if it would work, but...
Destiny is a funny thing.
Oh my gosh. Guys. eyes. She touches Zuko's scar, but more importantly, he lets her. There was that first girl that tried to touch it and he was like, LOL, no. Then there was Jin. She didn't try to touch it and they kissed. He is willingly allowing Katara to touch his scar. Guys, that's intimate. Whether you ship Zuko and Katara or not, she is the only one in the entire show to ever full on touch Zuko's scar. So at this point, I had to look it up. I was getting too invested, and your girl's been burned before with couples that look so obviously like their endgame, and then they end up not being. Yeah, Klaus and Caroline, I'm talking about you. Vampire Diaries originals and all that mess. But let's not. I've been burned before. By this point, I think I had already spoiled myself the first time around. But I was still getting upset. Why are you putting this in here? Why are you letting them have this moment if you were just going to rip it away and let it not mean that they're gonna be together? Whew! And it's only gonna get worse from here, so I need to calm down. Aang! Yeah, Aang knows. Aang knows what happened.
We'll catch up with you.
Guys, the look back. The look back. When has there ever been a couple that walks away and looks back at each other and they don't get together? Excuse me? Every couple. It is required. If you don't want us to ship them, don't give them lingering stares. Don't make Katara be the only one that touches his scar. Don't make both of them mutually look back at each other with longing. Guys. So dramatic. Oh! Oh! Ah!
I thought you had changed!
I have changed.
Look at them. Oh, the betrayal. Up, oh, when you and your future in-laws don't get along.
The only way is to let her go.
Sorry, Katara.
Oh my gosh, so I forgot about this. I didn't realize he actually did let her go to get into the Avatar state. Good job, Aang. Yes. He let her go to open his chakras and get into the Avatar state. I would have loved if any romantic tie with Katara had ended right there. So at the end of season 2, the romance part is done. Just friends. Ooh, honey. I'm not laughing, sorry, that was not a chuckle. Katara's mad, she's coming in on a wave. Guys, again, did not see this the first time around. That pose, the way that she's holding him, is very similar to a very famous sculpture called La Pietà. Look at me in my one class of art history from college. The sculpture is of Mary holding the dead body of Jesus once he's taken off the cross. And it's the exact same positioning. That just further reiterates the mother-child dynamic for me. I don't know if they did that intentionally, but her concern, it's very motherly, you guys. Could you imagine if it had ended there and there was no kind of hope, there was just that cliffhanger? I would have preferred it, but that's kind of dark for a kid's show. Oh, yay. She was willing to heal his scar. Honestly, I'm glad that she didn't, and I understand what they were doing. They were basically reminding the audience that she still had that water because it was gonna come into play at the end of the episode. But the fact that she was willing to heal Zuko's scar also says a lot. This is my favorite season. So much happened. Season 1, there's a lot of buildup, and again, a lot of waiting to get to the North Pole. In this season, Toph comes in by episode 5-6, and he's consistently learning earthbending throughout the entire season. Also, we meet Azula, we meet Ty Lee, we meet Mei, Suki comes back, Jet comes back, Appa gets lost, Appa gets found, we go to Ba Sing Se. To me, there really wasn't a filler episode. You could maybe count Tales of Ba Sing Se. I wouldn't. The only episode that I thought was the weakest is Avatar Day. At the same time, we learn about Kyoshi, so is it really a weak episode? Just consistently throughout. And then Toph is in this season. Hands down, this is the best season. Wow, this video is gonna be long. Which I knew, but oh my gosh. All right, on to season 3. Last season. All right, here we go.
Aren't you cold? I've got a lot on my mind.
over 3 years since I was home. I wonder what's changed, how I've changed.
I just asked if you were cold. I didn't ask for your whole life story.
So this is the first interaction we've seen of Zuko and Mei. He's bearing his heart to her and she brushes him off. Already puts me in a mood. Your boyfriend has just been exiled for 3 years and you're not gonna take what he's saying seriously and listen to him? That's already a strike against Mei. Another strike against Mei is we have not seen this relationship develop. I didn't leave it in. There is an episode where it's shown that Mei had a crush on Zuko when they were kids. But in no way did they explain how Zuko fell back in love with Mei. We don't see that. They fell into a fountain. Okay, where did the crush become mutual? So that all happened off screen. All we see here is them making out and her not being supportive. It's not a good look.
Everything okay?
We're fine, Dad.
I'm Katara and Sokka's father.
He knows who you are. Would you mind giving us a little privacy?
Katara back at it with the grudges. He got a temper on him too.
You're a crazy old man, and if you weren't in jail, you'd be sleeping in a gutter.
Would you look at that? Katara playing Aang's mom, doing fabulously at it. It's second nature. Wow.
You're so beautiful when you hate the world.
You're so beautiful when you hate the world. Ew. Mei, you are rich and lovely and privileged. What do you have to hate the world for? But you're on Tumblr talking about I am the half-empty shampoo bottle in the shower of life. This episode.
Wow, they look pretty good together.
If that's what you like.
Katara being jealous? I hate it. No 14, 15-year-old is gonna be jealous of a 12, 13-year-old. This whole episode, I don't like. It's, again, very... We had another one of those moments. They dance and sparks fly. And that's it? We've seen that before. We've seen it done before, but better. For instance, Confessions of a Shopaholic. Can't believe I'm referencing this in an Avatar video. Y'all ever seen that flawless film? In the script, all that was said was, they dance. Isla Fisher comes out with this fan and she starts doing this tribal thing. And it's hilarious because they took the expectations and flipped them on its head. That's what I needed this scene to do. These are nitpicks, right? But I'm holding this show to a higher caliber because I've seen what it can do. In my personal headcanon, Katara's dancing with someone else. Or Katara doesn't want to dance. Aang grabs Toph to dance. He's leaping in the air and stuff, so she can't always see him. So she's kind of having to interpret where he is and what he's doing based off of the vibrations in the ground. Maybe it's slightly off. Earth bends and yeets someone. Oh! Something more fun, more creative. I got kind of excited at the beginning when he was infiltrating the Fire Nation classes, learning about their version of history. That's interesting to me. I would have much rather seen him talking to other students and really getting the tea than seeing them just dance. I went on a tangent there.
Look at this place. We have to do something to help.
The Painted Lady episode.
Katara?
Hi, Aang.
You're the Painted Lady?
So the thing that we get from this is that both Zuko and Katara are into roleplay. And I hear the comments.
Everyone in the gang has dressed up at some point.
Yes. Yes. However, who are the only two that dressed up as something in the Fire Nation that signified hope and helped the masses? Blue Spirit, Painted Lady. Zuko and Katara, people. Yeah, they're not together. Make it make sense! I don't understand.
Sokka, you really do have a heart. He does have a heart, doesn't he?
I love it. I love it. Sokka's in the same kneeling position that Zuko was in front of his father. But you see the difference between having a supportive, healthy mentor versus Zuko's dad.
You noodle brains don't know what you're doing. I miss Sokka. If you miss him so much,
why don't you marry him?
Okay, so let's address this now. This is what I've really started realizing. Oh, wait a second. The show is emphasizing Toph and Sokka as a potential relationship. I personally don't support it for a couple reasons. One, Sokka already has a gorgeous, fantastic, fierce girlfriend in Suki. And I don't want to push her aside just because I love Toph so much. Second of all, my voice is getting hoarse. There's still the age factor to consider. Sokka's 15, Toph is 12. Just because the gender switch, I still have the same viewpoint when it comes to the age difference. Again, like a 10th grader being in love with a 6th grader? Absolutely not. He never returns the romantic feelings. I can understand her having a crush though. Everything could be totally different 15, 20 years from now, but I'm talking about in the show.
Sokka! We missed you!
They missed you or something.
It's weird that they keep hinting. When I was watching this for the second time to take these notes, I took a really big break from watching in these early season 3 episodes. Sokka gets a sword. Katara role plays. To me, they're filler.
This is for you.
Why would I want that?
Don't girls like stuff like this?
Maybe stupid girls.
May being rude for no reason. He's trying to be nice.
Thanks. This is so pretty.
Not as pretty as you are.
That shell's not so great.
Shade. Oh my gosh, Zuko, that's so dramatic.
That's a sharp outfit, Chan.
Azula's fun in this episode. This is a nice, different side to see.
Because it's so sharp.
This episode is fun. And I think what the issue is, I figured it out, again, watching it multiple times. Any episode with Zuko is great in season 3. I think they struggled with, we have to get Zuko to the point where he can join the gang. But he's not there yet. So we have to work on him, further his storyline, and we don't really know what to do with Aang. So everything with Zuko, it's building, he's having a mental crisis, and then Aang's over here dancing and waiting on Sokka to get a sword, going and helping a village with the Painted Lady, and it's just very stagnant with Aang, and Zuko's growing. The season really comes alive when the two come together. But right now, Aang's running in a circle and Zuko just keeps growing to where he needs to get to. That's what I think the issue is. And honestly, I don't know how I would change it. That's tough.
I'm bored.
I know.
I'm hungry.
So what?
Find me some food.
Am I too old? Am I supposed to be enjoying this? Am I supposed to think that that's funny? Y'all are bringing out the worst in each other. Why are y'all together? I don't like this. Again, I feel like I would feel this way whether I wanted Zuko to be with Katara or not.
Well, at least I feel something. You're just a big blah.
It's over, Zuko. We're done.
Thank God. Oh, he's going to the beach, to the shore, where there's what? Water! Take me to McQueen!
Why don't you just mind your own business? In your little Ty Lee world where everything's great all the time, circus freak.
Do you have any idea what my home life was like? 6 sisters who look exactly like me? At least I'm different now. Circus freak is a compliment.
Go ahead, Ty Lee. Of the Azula, May, Ty Lee trio, Ty Lee is undoubtedly my favorite. Zuko had no right to come at her like that.
Attention issues. What's your excuse, May? You were an only child for 15 years. But even with all of that attention, your aura is this dingy, pasty, gray.
Yes, go off, Ty Lee.
I'm sorry I can't be as high-strung and crazy as the rest of you.
I wish you would be high-strung and crazy for once, instead of keeping all your feelings bottled up inside.
You know who doesn't have a problem keeping their feelings bottled up inside?
Everybody looks to the left. I'm completely
calm! Leave me alone!
I like it when you express yourself.
Don't touch me!
Zuko and May picking fights. Again.
My life hasn't been that easy either, May.
Whatever.
My dad thinks I'm a hero! Everything should be perfect, right?
This was also very hard to cut down. This whole conversation is all great. Also, he keeps turning out and looking at the water.
I'm angry at myself!
And this whole conversation hit stronger the second time. He's looking at the water!
I know one thing I care about. I care about you.
What? Girl, just 2 seconds ago, you were being so dismissive and so rude to him. And now y'all are making out again? Girl, back off.
Bad news, Chan.
Party's over.
This is a fun episode. Again, this is a good episode because it's all about Zuko. So this one is fine. It's the other ones.
The beach did help us learn about ourselves. I'll always remember this. Roku, it's that girl who didn't even know you were alive.
I was persistent. When love is real, it finds a way. And being the Avatar doesn't hurt your chances with the ladies either.
No, Roku, don't tell Aang that. First of all, that's not true. She did know Roku was alive. She liked Roku. Then he was persistent, and then they got together. Now Aang's gonna think, oh, because I'm the Avatar, I should be able to pursue who I want because I'm the Avatar. Who wouldn't love me? Bad advice, Roku. And especially because I know where it's going, Aang really does feel, in some way, entitled to Katara. He's like, well, I love you. You're mine. Oh, honey, no. Another Queen Top episode. Here we go, the Blind Bandit.
I won! Where did you guys get the money to buy all this stuff?
She used earthbending to win the game.
I cheated a cheater. This isn't something we should make a habit of doing.
Oh, how soon we have forgotten. Is Katara coming at Toph for stealing when she stole a water's bending scroll in the first season and said, oh, I can steal because I'm stealing from pirates. And now she's over here judging? This is Katara's character. So as much as I'm like, ugh, you know what? It's consistent.
Katara, I'll personally make you an Avatar promise that we won't make a habit of doing these scams.
So Aang lied. Again, I feel like lies should block chakras. Do they not? As a monk, as an air nomad, he should be against lying. Toph being fabulous. Fabulous! Perfection. Oh my gosh, it's the hawk.
The runaway. Is that what you're called now? Don't you walk away from me while I'm talking to you.
Oh, really, Mom? Or what are you going to do? Send me to my room? Well, you can't. You think it's your job to boss everyone around, but it's not. Stop acting like you can tell me what to do. I can do whatever I want.
We love it. I have noticed every time Katara and Toph have a little spat, I am on Toph's side. If I'm not on Toph's side, I understand Toph's side. The only time where it was a little questionable is when Toph wouldn't help out unloading all of the equipment. However, she is a rich only child that has not had to work with a team before. Give her some time, and Toph had good comebacks. She was like, look, I'm here, aren't I? And I got my stuff, so we just worked. Katara kept coming at her. Leave the queen alone. Also, ding ding, yes, Mommy Katara. Okay, sorry.
Aang, do I act like a mom?
Well, I...
Stop rubbing your eye and speak clearly when you talk.
Yes, ma'am.
Aang's into it. He's like, I never had a mom. I love you. Yeah, Hawkeye leaves and we never see him again. I'm just like, why?
They put us in prison.
Ooh, this episode.
I was the only one who managed to escape. I realized that where there is life, there is water, and I passed years developing the skill that would lead to my escape. Blood bending.
This episode was a pleasant surprise when I first started watching the show, and Aang wasn't that good at other types of bending. Zuko was throwing fire at him, and Aang was trying to air ninja himself away from it. I remember looking at the screen and just being like, Aang, you're an airbender. Lungs, air, choke him, leave. Just so you can get away. Don't kill him. That was frustrating to me, and it kind of comes up in Korra. That's all I'm gonna say. So this was a nice alternative. You can bloodbend someone. It's honestly very cool. Also, I completely relate to Katara. Her and Hama are like if I, as a black woman, met someone that survived slavery. I don't even go that far back. Someone who survived civil rights era. Those are like my grandparents. And by the way, the image that went around with Kamala Harris and the shadow on the wall of Ruby Bridges. Ruby Bridges is in her 60s. She just got her AARP card. She is not that old. Everyone thinks that happened such a long time ago. It wasn't. Anyway, when you meet someone that went through that, suffered through all that, triumphed through all that, so I can sit here and make an Avatar reaction video and not have to worry about getting lynched, there's a sense of reverence. I think they got that aspect of it down very well with her reactions to Hama. However, they make Hama out to seem like an evil character. But she's not. Hama is right. Listen to what she's saying.
Katara, they tried to wipe us out, our entire culture. Your mother.
I know.
They threw me in prison to rot, along with my brothers and sisters. We're the last waterbenders of the Southern Tribe. We have to fight these people whenever we can, wherever they are, to win this war.
She's not wrong, and I understand that what she's doing is wrong. It's not because she's evil. She is a victim of colonization. Makes perfect sense for her to be like, down with the colonizers. I'm here with her. Yes, they're making her seem creepy, when really she lost her culture, she lost her people. She escaped, but escaped to what? Now she has to live undercover in the nation that put her in a cage for years. No justice served. I completely understand that she would feel some type of way. But they're playing the sinister music. Don't make her that one-dimensional.
You're going to be locked away forever. My work is done.
He says you're going to be locked away forever. She has a slick, snide comment. No, she worked and developed a whole new form of bending to escape the cage. If someone told her you're going back in a cage, the more realistic reaction would be for her to break down. At least for me. I would have loved it if they had shown her getting put back in a cage and she just fell to her knees and just sobbing.
You're a bloodbender.
She leaves and she cackles. Katara's crying. Why? Bloodbending is a very cool thing, and they make it seem like it's so bad. Oh yeah, if you guys don't know, in Legend of Korra, bloodbending is made illegal. That's such colonialism behavior. Oh, you managed to invent a new form of bending? You had the audacity to get creative and innovative and escape the horrific situation that we put you in? Illegal!
I just wanted to pop in and further explain what I meant by typical colonizer behavior. What Hama was using bloodbending for was not good, right? There could be potential alternative uses for bloodbending that are positive. Maybe bloodbending is a way for waterbenders to heal people without having to lug around water with them at all times. Or maybe there's something else that we haven't even considered yet. We don't explore those other potential uses because the Fire Nation, the colonizer in this case, bloodbending was used against them. They don't understand it. And they can't control it. For those three reasons, it is immediately shut down. And that is what I mean by typical colonizer behavior, because that is what colonizers do. With different cultures, with different people, with anything they don't understand and therefore see as threatening.
I was not expecting to get this heated, I'm sorry. When I watched it again, I just realized they really made her look like a villain. Everything that she's doing, it's not from a place of evil. It's because she is hurt. I wish they had been a little bit more nuanced with it, especially because of the parallels that I can definitely see. I think the writers even knew the parallels they were making, and I think it should have been handled a little bit better. Another thing I would have also loved to see, at the end of season 3, when Zuko goes to the jail to talk to his father, Hama is in that jail. They start talking. Hama starts telling him about all the stuff that happened to the Southern Water Tribe. Then Zuko's like, you know what? Number one thing I'm gonna do as Fire Lord, reparations! Reparations for the Southern Water Tribe, especially because my wife is from there. I had to. Oh my gosh, this episode.
It's the nightmares. Nothing helps. I'm gonna stay awake straight through to the invasion.
Do you think you can find a fresh fruit tart for the lady?
Let's give a little round of applause. This is the first pleasant conversation between Zuko and Mei. Again, I'm gonna give flowers where flowers are due. Not annoying conversation. Good job, y'all.
What you need is a back pounding to relieve your stress.
Pound oh my away. Gosh.
I love it. I don't know why, I just love that interaction so much. They're fabulous.
You know what will make you feel better?
Ordering some servants around. Maybe a little palanquin ride around town?
The privilege is too real. Now this is my thing with Zuko and Mei. I feel like Mei is relating to Zuko like he never left the Fire Nation. She's asking him if he wants bougie treats to go on bougie rides. He's like, I was literally exiled and was eating scraps and had to work, was being chased around. She can't relate and she's not listening and trying to relate.
Aang, staying up all night can't be good for you.
I see everything so clearly now. I'm doing it to save the world, but more than that, I love you.
What are we doing?
What our hearts have been telling us for a long time. You're my forever girl.
Oh. Hey. Oh, y'all. When I first saw this, I was shook. Oh my gosh, it's a dream. Thank God. But honestly, every time these two get romantic, that drool close-up, that's what I envision in my mind now. So thank you, show, for giving me a visual for the sentiments I have behind this couple.
So, how did it go?
This is what I wrote. Mei cares about him. I'll give her that, but she does not understand him anymore. She represents what would have been the natural progression of their relationship had Zuko not been in exile for 3 years. She doesn't get it. Yeah, this episode is probably my least favorite of the whole series because it had all this crazy dream stuff too.
Hi, Katara.
Woo! Haru's back! With facial hair. That was a choice. Oh, but more importantly, Haru's dad is back!
You helped us find our courage, Katara. Now we're here to help you.
When did they sit for that portrait? Oh, it's not gonna be Mei. This is the wife, Aang, not Katara.
We've been through so many things together. You're not that little goofy kid I found in the iceberg anymore. I'm really proud of you.
When we first met, you couldn't even crawl. And now look at you. You're walking. I'm so proud of you, Bibbo.
What if I don't come back? Of course you'll.
Okay, see, this feels like a first kiss to me. The fact that he went 110% for her negative 10. Very symbolic of their relationship. Yeah. Y'all see that side eye she gave? The kiss ended and she went. Okay, so the sword is somewhat useful. So his episode with the sword wasn't too fluff.
I know I've made some bad choices, but today I'm gonna set things right.
Yes! Yes! Yes!
Yes. So, you are alive after all. I've known about the invasion for months.
This is another strike against season 3. In season 2, Katara clearly saw that Azula, Mei, and Ty Lee had dressed up as Kyoshi warriors. Don't you think she would have told the rest of the gang, hey, they might know a little something about our plan? The fact that the gang didn't even consider that, then all of a sudden we get there and she's like, yeah, I knew. And they're like, oh my gosh, what? One of you clearly knew that they were there. It's like insulting the kids' intelligence. Katara definitely would have told them. And then they should have been like, well, wait a second. Maybe we should, you know, adjust. But no, I don't like it.
All I wanted was for you to love me.
This was hard to cut down to. And I feel like this is the first time that we see Ozai's face, which is cool.
I'm going to join the Avatar, and I'm going to help him defeat you. Goodbye, coward.
And he's able to face his father and redirect lightning. Why? Waterbending. Here we go. Yes. Here we go. Here we go.
Hello. Zuko here. Hey. I'm good now. And, well, I think I should join your group and I can teach firebending. I know I've made some mistakes in the past.
When you stole my mother's necklace and used it to track us down and capture us?
You didn't steal your necklace, Katara. You dropped it and he picked it up. You just left it on the boat. If anything, you should be thanking him.
If you won't accept me as a friend, then maybe you'll take me as a prisoner.
No. She's reacting to him similar to how she reacted to Jed. Storytelling-wise, that's smart. You've set it up.
This is just like when we were in prison together.
Oh my gosh, she's talking about the cave. She's talking about how she caught feelings.
He was really confused and hurt. We can't trust him.
Aang needs a firebending teacher. Now one shows up on a silver platter and you won't even think about it?
I love that Toph is the first one to give Zuko a chance. Again, greatness recognizing greatness. Oh my. Because she has a point. Toph with the facts. Excuse me.
Let me help you. I'm sorry.
Awkward Zuko is fun. Oh my gosh.
You might have everyone else here buying your transformation. You make one step backward and you won't have to worry about your destiny because I'll make sure your destiny ends permanently.
Do I think Katara is secretly in love with Zuko here? No. Do I think this is a much more interesting, mature side of Katara? Absolutely. More of this, please. So I didn't realize the first time around, even though I spoiled myself, I didn't realize Zuko wasn't gonna join the gang until there was only 6 episodes left of the show. My hopes of them getting together in the show, I kind of dropped those because we don't have that much time. There is enough time to build up their relationship, and they do, to the point where you could leave it kind of open-ended. The chemistry is off the charts. They could have done that. I like seeing how they banter off each other a lot more than her with Aang. I feel like in the future, this is the pairing that would have happened. I really do. Her whole threatening conversation with Zuko was very much like a mama bear protecting her cub. If you ever step towards my baby again, I'ma kill you. I believe you, hon. I believe you.
Firebending. It's not lost, it's just weaker.
Maybe you're just not as good as you think you are. Ouch.
Giving Bae a hard time. It's been said before, and I'll say it again, the opposite of love is not hate, it's indifference. If we were giving out superlatives for the least indifferent to Zuko, it would definitely be Katara, hands down. So I'm just saying, the girl is paressed. We get more Toph backstory, thank God.
I don't care what everyone else says about you. You're pretty smart.
Look at that smile! But who said Zuko was dumb? All right, we're gonna pause for a sec. Okay, your girl's got 10% left on her battery. Let's see if we can get this done. I don't know.
Seriously, don't tell anyone.
With
this technique the dragon showed us, Zuko and I will be unstoppable.
Didn't he just tell you not to tell anyone? Aang and Zuko. Excuse me.
I can't remember how it starts, but the punchline is, leave me alone. I'm bushed. It's funnier when Uncle tells it.
Right. Maybe that's because he...
More banter between bays.
I'm gonna rescue my dad. You happy now? I'm never happy.
I'm never happy. We saw that smile, Zuko. Stop it.
My first girlfriend turned into the moon. That's rough, buddy.
The line, a moment that I didn't realize how iconic it was. Suki! Love them. Love them. Fabulous. Wonderful. Yes.
If you two are done cuddling, can we get a move on?
Zuko and Sokka. That's a ship now.
All I get is a letter.
This isn't about you. This is about the Fire Nation.
You're betraying your country.
That's not how I see it.
May, that's what I've been saying. Y'all are not on the same page here. If that's the case, and we're in season 3, I don't understand why you two are together still. She doesn't get it. Let's raise one to Suki. Being a queen, not just talk.
Sorry, Warden, you're my prisoner now.
This is just a fabulous episode. Parts 1 and 2. Yeah, I didn't write a lot of notes. I just enjoy these episodes.
You miscalculated. I love Zuko more than I fear you.
May's iconic line. The thing is, I believe her. I believe that she loves Zuko, but they're still not understanding each other. As much as I can appreciate that she cares about him and in the end that she saved him, that doesn't change that fact. Here we go, y'all. Here we go.
What are you doing?
Keeping rocks from crushing you.
You can get off me now.
Keeping rocks from crushing you? Katara was not the only one under the rocks. Did y'all see? Suki was there too, Zuko. Why didn't you go and save Suki? You went right past Suki to save Katara. Oh. He's like, I don't care about Suki. First of all, how dare you?
I am about to celebrate becoming an only child.
Azula, that's dark. Yikes. So Zuko saved Katara, and then Katara returns the favor. Someone on Tumblr was like, it's the push and pull for me. It's the tui and la for me.
To Zuko.
Hear, hear.
You guys, again, she's got some intense feelings. Yes, y'all go discuss your feelings.
This isn't fair. Everyone else seems to trust me now. What is it with you?
Oh, everyone trusts you now? I was the first person to trust you.
What can I do to make it up to you?
You could bring my mother back.
At the water. Again, looking out towards the water, y'all.
Well, hello. What's on your mind? Your sister.
Your sister. Your sister.
Your sister. Yes. Yes. I can't even do the thing. Last time I recorded, I like jumped up and down.
Yes.
Then my headphones come off.
Tell me what happened to your mother. Katara mentioned it before when we were imprisoned together in Ba Sing Se.
Homeboy's been taking notes? He's remembering the whole conversation they had. Come on now.
The main ship had flags with sea ravens on them. The Southern Raiders. Thanks, Sokka.
You look terrible.
I waited out here all night.
When Bay waits up all night for you. But I don't know, waiting up all night for someone, that's not love, because he loves Mei. So if he loved Katara, he would have left her a letter to break up with her. Or locked her up in a jail cell.
Revenge is like a two-headed rat viper.
That's cute, but this is an air temple preschool.
What? Zuko just called Aang a preschooler. Yes!
Katara, she was my mother too. I think Aang might be right.
Then you didn't love her the way I did.
Katara.
Katara, that was wrong. You shouldn't have done that.
This is a journey you need to take. You need to face this man.
So glad you come around to Zuko and Katara's way of thinking, Aang.
Your mother was a brave woman.
Subtext, you're a brave woman too, Katara. Looking like Bonnie and Clyde. Yes. Guys, they work well together. Woo! Just being supportive. He's like, this journey is not about me. So whatever you need to do, Katara, do you. Do you, boo. Love you.
You're the little water drag girl.
She was protecting the last waterbender.
Who?
Me!
Yes. Yes!
Forgiveness is the first step you have to take to begin healing. I'm proud of you. I'll never forgive him, but I am ready to forgive you.
Zutara hug!
Oh! Violence wasn't the answer.
It never is.
Then I have a question for you. What are you gonna do when you face my father?
Good question, Zuko! And guys, we are here. Ember Island Players. My favorite episode of the whole shebang. There's so much. It's so perfect. All right, here we go.
Ember Island reveals the true you.
Very important. In the recap, the woman reminds us Ember Island reveals the true you. Keep that in mind. Going forward, you see Toph and Katara sitting there? Wives watching their husbands do the work, shirtless.
Who is the boy in the iceberg?
Genius. Genius. You know what that's like? Very
Draco Malfoy!
Energy. Fabulous. Zuko seems just to be sitting there enjoying it. This side of the story, he doesn't know. He's just like, is this what you guys did while I was chasing you around?
They make me look stiff and humorless.
I think that actor's pretty smart.
More banter.
How could you say that?
It's obvious that the playwright did his research. What you're seeing up there on that stage is the truth.
Preach, Toph! Queen Toph! And we'll talk about this now. Every time Toph has been on screen, she has been flawless. From beginning to the end, Toph has not made one mistake in my book, and she is fabulous. I don't think I can think of a show where a character has been this consistently perfection before. Yeah. Yeah. As much as I'm giving my thoughts on this show, the fact that from day one I've been Team Toph is an accomplishment that is very rare. All of the awards go to Toph, Beifong, Queen Melon Lord, love of my life and my heart. She is definitely in the flawless squad, but she is also not alone. There are a few people that I would put from this show in the flawless squad. Toph is the leader. Suki, she has also been flawless the entire show. And Ty Lee. Toph, Suki, Ty Lee. That's my flawless squad. For those of you in the comments that are gonna be like, what about Uncle Iroh? I love Uncle Iroh, he's great. He's not in the flawless squad though, because he was, this is more towards the beginning of the show, he was a little too flirtatious with teenage girls. He was definitely flirting with June. He wanted to pretend he was knocked out so she could still lay on top of him. I don't know how I feel about this. Other than that, he was great, but I remember that though. I think the three I picked are very objectively flawless. The other two that I would also put in my personal flawless squad are Meng. And June delivering the facts, the whole show. Toph, Suki, Ty Lee, Meng, June. Now that we have that established.
This must be where I come in.
My name's Toph.
I sound like a really buff
yes.
guy.
Yes.
I wouldn't have to yeah. talk to any other way. At least it's not a flying bald lady.
Did Jet just die? You know, it was really unclear.
Was it unclear though? His death was pretty clear. Let me know what you guys thought.
I have to admit, Prince Zuko, I've had eyes for you since the day you first captured me.
Yes, it's true.
Besides, how could he ever find out about this?
Again, we are on Ember Island, the island that reveals the true you. And what's on Ember Island? The fact that Zuko and Katara have romantic feelings for each other. And the way they're reacting to it is typical secret crush behavior. Also, I don't like when stage Zuko was like, aren't you the Avatar's girl? Aang did a little...
Excuse me.
When did you ever define the relationship, Aang? Y'all kissed... In my book, y'all kissed once. I guess in the show's book, y'all kissed twice. I don't know how you drew the conclusion that she's your girl.
He's like a little brother to me.
Nothing came of it. Wait, let me go back. This is my favorite part.
Avatar's date! Yip,
yip! My uncle taught me so much. How do I repay him? With a knife in his back.
All your uncle wanted was for you to find your own path and see the light. He'd be proud.
That was so sweet. This is a flawless episode. It's Toph in an episode.
Ow!
That's how I show affection.
So hitting people is how she shows affection. Interesting. Interesting.
Katara, did you really mean what you said in there? When you said I was just like a brother to you, an actor said that. But it's true, isn't it?
Yes! It's true! We're on Ember Island, it's true!
I'm sorry, but right now I'm just a little confused.
She's not confused, Aang! Girls, Well, everyone really. We know what this is. Someone likes you and you don't feel the same way, but you're trying not to hurt their feelings. You are being very cautious and kind about it, but you don't feel anything. Aang is not picking up on those clues and he's not listening to her.
I just said I was confused.
She told him she was confused. And he kisses her? No consent in sight. If y'all shipped Aang and Katara, I feel like the shipping should have ended right here. When she ran away, I was like, oh, okay, it's done. It's done. I was so happy too. I don't see how you could ship them after that. Because he's not listening to her. He just wants what he wants. Mm-mm.
Here's what you missed. We went to the Fire Nation, and you got better, and Katara was the Painted Lady, and I got a sword, and I think Combustion Man died.
Interesting. So even in the recap episode, they completely skip over the first half of season 3. The episodes that I didn't like, they have Sokka do it in a 3-second spiel, and they don't even bother animating it. There could be two reasons for that. One, because we just saw the episodes not too many weeks ago. Or two, because on the grand scheme of things, they're not important. The first half of this season dragged.
Aang, I'll always love you like a brother.
I wouldn't want it any other way.
How it should have ended. And then they cut to Aang in between Zuko and Katara, sitting together.
The comet is already here. I'm unstoppable.
This is my favorite episode, but it's a very bittersweet love. When I watched it, one, was not expecting it, and it was fantastic. And it was confirming everything that I felt while watching the show. They said everything on Ember Island is true. Zuko and Katara have feelings for each other. Katara only sees Aang as a friend. Toph is the best thing in the play, and that's facts. Everything is getting confirmed for me. I'm like, okay, now I know where we're going. In retrospect, writers, you knew how to end the show. You just showed me the perfect ending on that stage, minus Aang dying, but that's because we're in the Fire Nation. You put it right in front of me, only to take it away a couple episodes later. It left me so astonished. How? What? Best episode, a surprise delight. So the phone died, but we're back. We're back. We're in the final episode.
I've been working on my sand bending.
Toph being queen again. She's always self-improving. But even more than that, her inability to see in the sand is what led to Appa getting kidnapped. The fact that she's been practicing, she's like, okay, I feel responsible, so I'm going to ensure that that never happens again. I love that. Queen.
Ta-da! It's Suki.
I think it's sweet.
This put me firm in Suki is best girl. Cause I was kind of like, okay, people like Toph and Sokka. No, Suki is the best girlfriend. I asked my roommate, what do you think about Toph and Sokka? Cause I like Suki and Sokka. And she said, well, honestly, I think Suki's too good for Sokka. And I'm like, you know what? You're right. Sokka is very aware of that fact. I don't think Sokka would have ever left Suki. If anything, she would have dumped him. This is the one couple that they got right. So of course we don't see them in Legend of Korra. Looks like a powerful bender to me. I don't know. What do you guys think?
What's wrong with you? You could have hurt Aang.
Days before the final showdown, babying Aang.
What's wrong with me? How can you sit around having beach parties when Sozin's Comet is only 3 days away?
Get over here, Zuko.
Katara called Zuko over for the group hug. I am Melon Lord. They're always getting paired together. They look fabulous together. Guys.
None of you understands the position I'm in. Aang, don't walk away from this.
Let him go.
Yes, Katara, let him go. It's the return of the ultimate Zutara fangirl, June.
I don't know who this June lady is, but I like her.
Yes, Toph.
I see you work things out with your girlfriend.
She's not my girlfriend.
Denial. Denial!
I am Avatar Yanchen. This isn't about you. This is about the world.
Oh my gosh!
Your sole duty is to the world.
Say it again for the people in the back.
Do whatever it takes to protect the world.
This ain't about you, Aang. Yes, Aang. I called her Aang Chen. Yes, Avatar Yang Chen.
Are you okay?
So Zuko is opening up to Katara. Watch how she is super supportive and gives him actual advice versus Mei, who yawned and brushed it off. She's like, listen, if I can forgive you, Zuko, I'm sure your uncle can forgive you. And she was right.
I can handle Azula.
You'll need help.
You're right. Katara.
Do you see how fast? Yeah, I need someone to help me face my sister. Be with me in this very crucial point in my life. Didn't even have to think about it. Katara!
How would you like to help me put Azula in her place?
Would you like to be my wife and help me beat your future sister-in-law? And what does she say?
It would be my pleasure.
So here we have the Lion Turtle reveal. I've watched this multiple times, as I've said. This really does feel out of nowhere. We had the one reference in the library, but other than that, it felt like all the previous avatars were telling him, hey, you need to do this. Morality is a very gray thing, and I know that this is tough for you, but you also have to look beyond what your personal principles are when you are responsible for the entire world. I thought that was gonna be the lesson, but then nope, JK, oh, here's something that can easily fix Aang's problem. So you didn't really have to challenge your beliefs. You didn't really have to grow in any way. You just had to be at the right place at the right time. An easy way to fix this issue would be when he's talking to one of the previous avatars, they could have said, well, you could talk to the original benders. Original benders? Who are the original benders? Lion turtles. What are lion turtles? And then either they don't know or they've never met one or something. And then he's on the island and he goes, wait, this island is moving. I was on a lion turtle this whole time. Seamless versus, oh yeah, remember that thing that we mentioned in season 2, episode 11? It's back! Ah! They're back together again.
I'm worried about Aang.
I love that Zuko's now the worried dad. They're worried parents. Their kid has to walk on their own now. I'm so in love. I can't take all this love. It's so amazing.
You're going down.
Yo, when you're in law, be crazy. Crazy. Ooh. No. Oh my gosh! Sacrifice!
Zuko!
Now, people have pointed out, Zuko would have leapt in front of the lightning for anyone who was standing there. To which I say, yes, that's true. Zuko has grown and he would have protected whoever came with him to fight Azula. However, who did he come ask to fight with him with less than 2 seconds of think time? So that argument, while valid, is counterbalanced by the other argument, so. The sword barely came into play, so I don't know why we needed a whole episode.
Looks like this is the end.
Y'all, if Toph had died right here, it would have been like Finnick all over again. You know what? I don't even want to talk about it.
Did Boomerang come back?
No, Suki did.
Suki! Y'all, this is cool. Yes. Ooh. Y'all, how are they gonna make this live action? He made himself a whole planet. Ooh, Katara! Contain the demon. Drown the evil in-law. Yes, she heals him. This is like Jet, but Jet died. But Zuko lived.
Thank you, Katara.
Ugh.
I think I'm the one who should be thinking.
This is really sad. Hand on the back! Hand on the back. Guys, this is cool because it's like the beginning in the pilot. When he broke free from the iceberg, a big beam of blue came out. It's mirrored at the end. Oh, look at that! The water is soothing the destruction of the Fire Nation. Interesting!
You need some help with that?
Ugh! No! May! No! Why is she here? How did she grow? What did she learn? When she was in Boiling Rock, she still thought that Zuko was doing the wrong thing. When did she have a come to Jesus moment and realize, oh yeah, maybe we should stop colonizing and destroying the world? Why are they together? No! Oh, I hate it. I'm happy that Zuko's happy, but story-wise, I don't understand. Who's that little boy hugging Toph? Aang, get your girl!
The girls and I really bonded in prison.
What a statement. What a queen. Flawless squad, Ty Lee.
I can't believe a year ago my purpose in life was hunting you down.
And now we're friends.
Yeah, we are friends.
Whose arc is more satisfying? I don't think it's Aang's. I think it's Zuko's. Because this is lovely.
Please, the real hero is the Avatar.
Yes, Humble King, yay! Aww. Fire Lord Zuko! What changed. He won the war, so you love him now? No, this makes Katara just feel like a prize because he defeated the Fire Lord. Do you understand? You didn't show what she did to come to romantic feelings towards him. She's just like the cherry on top. My girl Katara deserves more than that. Especially, what's also adding to this anger is what we see in Legend of Korra. I'm not. So certain characters get statues of them, cities in their honor. Katara gets none of that. Katara is the Avatar's girl. She has the kids and is a healer and stays in the Southern Water Tribe. Are you kidding me? Katara should also have a statue. Katara should have a city. But she doesn't because she had to stay home and take care of the kids while Aang was out doing whatever he had to do. And that's infuriating. He should have married Meng. Meng is the most obvious choice if he just wanted someone to stay at home and take care of the kids. The most interesting choice, yo, if Aang and Toph had gotten married or had gotten together and they had kids, oh, I would eat that show up. Because I know they probably wouldn't stay together. Toph would have fought back. She would have been like, I had these kids, but I'm about to build a city. Someone needs to take care of the kids. Why not you, Aang? I'm a guy. All the drama would have been so good. They're still compatible, but neither of them would give on their goals and their skills as benders. And it would have been very interesting to see. And to see how the kids would react to their parents. Katara deserves more. Again, I'm sorry for spoiling Legend of Korra, but it's just really frustrating. I know what I'm about to do in editing. I can already feel the wrath. The end. Y'all saw the sun up and sun down with me. That wasn't the intention, but thank God for ring lights. That was Avatar The Last Airbender. I want to reiterate, huge fan of the show. I love the Avatar The Last Airbender community. I love that it surged. I'm part of that surge. Just the fact that they made Toph Beifong, I'm a fan for life. I love the representation they gave and the empowerment they gave to someone who had a very visible scar that never got healed. I loved that. Toph was so amazing. The blindness just made her even more capable in the skill that she had. That's great. Integrated into the story so well. The world building is great. The story is great. There are things that I would definitely change. The main one being, I don't want Aang and Katara together. I want Zuko and Katara together. Open-ended, or like a hint. Because another thing that I would have loved to see, well, one, Aang having to come to terms with his girl liking someone else. That would have been a struggle that I would have liked to see Aang kind of work through and be like, you know what? It's okay. Hunchback Notre Dame, like that. Which I love Hunchback. Eventually, Zuko and Katara get together. That in itself would be a very interesting political move because of the state of the nation after the war. What would be even crazier is if they had a kid, and the kid, the future Fire Lord, is a waterbender. I have no idea what the repercussions of that would be, but I'd love to see it on screen. How Zuko and Katara have to handle it, how the kid has to handle it, how the Fire Nation handles it, how Aang probably has to handle it. I would have loved to see that. That's a personal thing. I'm so glad that this was one of the first things I watched in quarantine and have been rewatching and engaging with ever since. I just wanted to have something that I could look back on that really just encapsulates all of my feelings on this show. Especially about Zuko and Katara. I didn't realize it was such a huge fandom until after I finished the show. The fact that Dante ships it, so many people, it's huge. I love it. And I love the show. I love Toph. Michaela, hit me up. We should be friends. If you've watched this whole thing, thank you. Editing Rachel, girl. This has been a project since the summer of cutting this all down. If you've gotten to this point, congratulations. Congrats. You did it. You're done. Okay, it's late. I haven't eaten all day, actually. Is that a bug? Oh, gosh. Whenever there's another show or another movie or anything that inspires this much discourse, maybe we'll do this again. Until then, bye. Oh, man. It's gonna be a party editing this down.
Wake up. Post up. Run around in it. Blossom on it. This diamond. My diamond. This rock.